Ah, horror. I always say it can be split into one of two groups. They're either what I call body count anime or something with genuinely creepy characters. However, Ukami Kakushi is so pathetic I cannot fit it into either category. Hiroshi moved into a new town, and it's a horror, so the town has to have dark secrets connected to it and a warning to stay out of the old part of town, and cliche though this is, I'd say it's counterbalanced with the first 30 seconds where a girl with glowing red eyes professes her love to a Hiroshi that just peed his pants. It was one of those how-did-we-get-here beginnings. The town is weirdly obsessed with wolves. Their god is a wolf, you see a wolf statue from time to time, wolves are mentioned almost every episode, and by episode 3 or 4 I had reason to believe there were conditions where people turned into something werewolf-ish, but I won't spoil the truth of the matter. After two episodes, I've come to the conclusion the writer has never met another human being. Blondie falling in love upon eye contact, that's all fine and well. Hiroshi always being surprised by her playful advances starts to wear on my nerves, and come to think of it, I'm not sure why he didn't give her a proper answer before she had the glowing red eyes. Seems like turning her down, or agreeing to date her, would have saved him some awkwardness from his perspective. And it should be obvious not to stay out too late, right? It's stated there's no one walking around after dark, and there's a blood moon every night in this town, somehow, but you know this dunce found a reason to stay out late. Why? His sister left her hat at a friend's place. Even his sister was trying to tell him it's just a hat, and we were scheduled to visit her again the next day. But nothing would do, he had to be the good brother. As a mystery, I had most things figured out by episode 3. But I couldn't figure out the significance of Nimeru until her big reveal in episode 6. All I knew was she looks just like Rurichio from Inu X Boku SS. Ukami Kakushi has a general understanding of how a horror is supposed to progress. A calm before the storm, lightheartedness before spilling someone's blood. What it doesn't understand is that's the time to bring the characters to life just a little. Take Isuzu. Tell me why I care if she lives or dies. She has a nice bum bum. I have a nice bum bum too. She and I are practically cousins. Actually, I disagree with you, dum dum. She does not have a nice bum bum. I can draw a better bum bum while chewing gum gum. Pass me my rum rum. The series further botches things by trying for humor in the beginning, but could do no more than make me smile. Hey, Happy Sugar Life and Future Diary weren't comedies either, but they still told a joke when they felt like it and they were good when they did. The series can be salvaged for parts. The fight scene in episode 6 had lovely shots of the girl with glowing red eyes wielding knives screaming about her love, which tickles my yandere bone, motivating me to go a little longer until I ran out of motivation on episode 9 when the last of my questions were answered. The series had peace for the moment, and I didn't care enough to see if any other conflicts broke out in the last 3 episodes. Original though some of it may be, I don't recommend it. Chaos-kun. Ukami Kakushi is a no-account horror from 9 years ago, ranking south of 6,000 on MAL. You just helped us dodge a bullet that wasn't flying at anyone. Well, okay, fine, but for all I knew, it could have been a hidden treasure among horror anime that just didn't get too well known.